We're back. Well, go to Friendly Hood Pro for me. No, I'm joking. Anyway, so you get this great moment where he wakes up the next morning. Like, it's like, oh god, and you get the zoo animals, like the lions and all this other things. It's like, and monkeys and all this other stuff. And then he just kind of David wakes up, like, all naked. And he's like, oh god. He's like, okay, nice. He's in the cage and people are walking around like, nice, okay. It's like, and then you got a kid with balloons, you have a couple and all this. And it's like, nice. He gets up, he's like, okay. He gets up, gets out. Gets up and you see a bit of his dick. You see a bit of his bushy dick. And he's running away. And it's a great bit of humor. Because it's like, you know the way in werewolf films, they're going to wake up naked. And you're like, oh, fuck. Like, he partied too hard. He's like, oh, God. You know, he doesn't even know what's happening. He's like, running away and all that. And people run away. And a woman's like, oh. So, you know, that kind of shit. What's happening? And they're kind of like just looking or whatever. And he sees this kid just there, standing in there. And he's at the bus like, hey, kid. And the kid's like, what? He's like, hey, kid. He's like, what's wrong? The bush talking. He's like, hey, kid, get me something. He's like, no, can you? I'm not supposed to do that to you. I'm not supposed to talk to you. And he's like, oh, come on. Can you give me a balloon? He's like, no. Come on. Give me a balloon. I'm a special bush. I'm a special guy who can give you a balloon. He's like, all right, please. And he's so dressed, like, casually, like a proper British child. And he's like, he gets up, he's like, thanks, kid, takes the balloon. And then the guy, I love this. The kid just goes up to his mother and goes, yes, love, a naked American man stole my balloons. He's like, what? Really? And then it cuts to London and just all this, the busyness of the streets, like, ah, and you know. And it's getting to that point where it's like, okay, we're getting to a great finale here. And I find that this is one of the best finales in a horror film. It's really emotional, really well done. It's dark, and I love it. So essentially, they're walking around or whatever, and there's also that moment just before Hammer David runs past like an elderly couple, grabs a woman's like coat, puts it on, and then we get a shot in London, and you just get all these shots of people and then his feet, and he's just there, like, and people are just kind of looking at him. He's like, lovely weather we're having, isn't it? And all that. Gets home or whatever, like, where's David? He runs all the way home. He's like, oh my god, hi. He's like, oh, David, where were you? I was worried about you all night. It's like, oh god, I feel amazing. It's like, I stole a coat, I woke up naked in the zoo. It's like, what? And all that. And it's like, where'd you get the coat? It's like, I don't know, there it is. It's like, do you want it? Oh, you can keep it. And they're flirting, let's go out and do something. Like, come on, let's go out. And he puts on his clothes, and it's like, everything feels great. It's like, come on, I feel great. Like, David, what are you doing? I feel amazing. Come here. He's kissing her constantly. Kiss her. I feel amazing and stuff. This is great. Let's get a taxi. It's like, yeah. So, oh, it's amazing, David. So they get in the taxi. It's like, let's go this way, please. It's like, yeah. Do you all hear about the murder last night? It's like, murder? What murder? Bunch of people murdered by some like wild animal. And he just kind of goes, what? It's like, stop it. Stop it! Stop it! He's like, are you sure? I'm gonna get sick. Please stop the fucking car. He's like, what's happening? David! And then running away. And then you get this amazing fucking moment where it's like, David, please. It's like, oh my god, I done it. I killed those people. I fucking killed those people. He's like, no, you didn't, David. What are you talking about? I turned into it. I don't remember it, but I was a fucking animal. It's like, what? I can't. It's like, you need to relax, David. I can't relax. I'm a fucking werewolf and all this shit. It's like, please, like, he's like, I'm going up to a car to get asked to be arrested. David, no, please. He's doing something. He's like, please, officer. He's like, good day. He's like, please, can you arrest me? It's like, no, come on, move along. He's like, come on, I killed all those people last night. Can you please just arrest me? Can you please arrest me? He's like, no. He's like, no. He's like, please. He doesn't know what he's talking about. It's like, please, would you just shut up? I need you to arrest me. He's like, no. He's like, please, and all that. I killed those people. He's like, come on, move along now. Don't be embarrassing yourself. And everyone's around like, come on, please, arrest me. And then I'm sorry, I love this bit. I was talked about this in the first part of the review. This bit's fucking funny. Now, obviously, there is a slur used in this. I don't like this word, but it's just the way the delivery of the scene was very well done. So he's like, Queen Elizabeth was a lesbian. Prince Charles is a faggot. This place sucks. And all that. Like, please, like, sir, I'll... have to arrest you if you keep at this. I was like, that's what I want you to do, asshole. I want you to arrest me, you asshole. I was like, no, come on, David, let's go. It's like, I can't, I have to go. And there's people going off. And then she's like, David, where are you going? He's like, I gotta go. You gotta stay away from me, please. Like, come on, David, and all that. And, you know, you get this really emotional moment that I think is beautifully done. I mentioned it before. And now, trigger warning for people. I should have probably put a trigger warning the other time, but whatever. So you get a great shot of him in the phone box. Like, come on, let's go. It's like, are mom and dad there? Can you please tell her that they love him? Come on, just stop. Yeah, you little twerp, please. Tell them that I love them when I was your age. Come on. And tell them I love him. And tell them I love you too. Okay, thank you, bye. And then he just gets a knife and puts it to his wrist. And it's like, oh, damn it. And walks off. It's like, shit. That fucking shit was heavy. And she's walking around London. It's like, you know, she's like, David's in danger. It's like, oh, where is he? He's going crazy. We gotta help him. It's like, come on. So they're going, they're all running around and shit. And they're like trying to find where he is. Come on, the police are like, come on, let's go. So David ends up going, like, they're like, oh, here's come to this show. It's like, come on, sir, there you go, and all that. And they get newspaper and they go into this, like, he goes into this movie theater for like this porno. It's like, can I have one to this, please? Like, meh. How much is in? Oh, it's about £5, love. And all that. Go in, walk in. It's like, great. So they go into the movie theater, and I just think the scene is so well done. And it's a memorable scene. Like, the movie's called, like, whatever. And, like, I have to talk about this porno. In fact, the porno that they made in this movie, John Landis was actually thinking of making the actual film. Not an actual porno, but he was going to make the entire film, but it never got made as a spin-off to this, but it never got made. So goes in, it's like, what are you doing here? I don't know. It's like, sit down. It's like, hey, David, sit down. It's like, hi, Jack. It's like, hi, David. And then at this point, his whole face is almost like fucked up like a skeleton. And it's just, it's so well done, honestly. The fucking practical effects. It's like, hi. It's like, what are you going to do, David? It's like, got to kill myself. I don't know what's happening and all that. And he's like, this is awful, David. And he looks at me. He's like, and, you know, the girl's there with her titties, and he cuts to the movie, and she has her titties out, and they're fucking like, oh, yeah, yeah. And the guy walks in, you're at this shit again. And he's like, I don't know you. Sorry, I don't know. He's like, oh, really? Okay, I'm sorry. He walks out. He's like, good movie. He's like, yeah, I know, right? It's great. Look at those people. Like, who are those people? And then you actually see the previous fucking victims bloodied up and shit. It's like, this is him. It's like, it's like, hi, dude. It's like, hi, nice to meet you. It's like, this is him. Hi, him is his wife. Hi, it's like all the people he's killed. Like, this is her. Hi, and then this is him. It's like, you killed me. The guy who killed in the subway. And I have to explain to my wife and kids that I'm not got my wife and kids are now widowed and have no one to live with. Look, I'm sorry, please. I didn't mean it. It's like, you gotta do it, David. It's like, okay, I'll do it. And it's just this great dialogue that goes on. It's heartbreaking. It's like, oh, God. And he gets out. It's like, oh, no, what's happening? And then full moon is coming. It's like, you got to stop the full moon. And then you just get this amazing moment where he's like, no. And he's transforming again. The light in the eyes. And he just goes, rah, and all that. It's like, what's happening? And he just goes, ah. And there's people running out. Like, oh, God, what's happening? And, you know, and he's just like, and they're busted. It's like, oh, there's a werewolf. Help. And he's going out attacking people. And he's like, David. And they're running. And the cops are after him. Like, David, don't hurt him. And he's running. And they're like, oh, God. And then they're driving. Like, oh, shit. And they're like, you know, and he's going into alleyways. Like, come on. And then there's just like this great action sequence where like driving a car. Like, no, David, come on. And he's like, they're fucking attacking people. And he's like, come on. And it attacks the guy. He's like, come on, David, stop it. And they're shooting. He's like, come on, stop it. And it's like, miss, what are you doing? And all that. And she's trying to run after him, like, David, and runs underneath it. It's like, David, come on. And they're like shooting. And it's like, oh shit, the cars are there. Like, it's like, where are you? The doctor's there. It's like, David, come on. It's like, what are you doing? He goes underneath the thing and he's in the alleyway and he's just there, like, it's like, David, please. I love you, David. I love you, David. David, I love you. I love you, and all that. And then eventually they just all go, and they shoot him and kill him. And it's like, oh God. And he turns into a regular human, and it's blood. Like, oh my God, get him, pick him up. And he's like, no. And she's like, no, and starts crying. And then the music are like, ba, 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 da, da, da. Really fucking happy. Like a dark fucking ending. They actually had the balls to kill off the main character, which I love. The fact that they had the balls to kill him off. And then have a comedic, like a heartbreaking ending, love story in a way. And the comedic music, I just thought it was brilliantly done. I love this finale, how batshit crazy it is. And honestly, I love this movie. There's nothing wrong with it. This is a perfect horror comedy. It balances horror, comedy, romance, like a love story, likable characters, unlikable characters, levity, dark humor, brilliant direction, very well. American and British humor. It's sort of a Brit. It's more of a. It is a British movie technically. Like it's more of an American British film, but it's just brilliant. The locations in London, the countryside, the realistic setting. I love this film. The print on this Blu-ray is amazing. I know there is an Arrow version as well, and I know there's a Steelbook version in America, but it's an amazing film. Here's the front, spine. The back. I do prefer the original poster, which is the boys walking. Now, I often forget this. There is a sequel to this movie called An American Werewolf in Paris, and it looks like total fucking dog shit. Or sorry, werewolf shit. Anyway, there's also t-shirts of the slaughtered lamb you can get, which are pretty cool. But I haven't seen it, and I don't plan to. I probably will watch it someday just so I can review both movies, but not for a long time. So yeah, that was my movie review of American Werewolf in London. I hope you guys enjoyed. I give the movie a 10 out of 10. I will see you guys later. Bye.